Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the second episode to create an invitation app using JavaScript. In the previous episode, we had a quick preview of our demo site. Plus, we looked at our markup and run hello world using the alert function. Today, we'll create the ally and other necessary elements, and by using the event listener, we'll add the person's name when the form is submitted. First of all, let's use document.createElementselector to select form and input box and store them in variables. So open your text editor, open your index.html and app.js. You can then remove this alert function and create variable for form. I will call it form, and then let's use document.createElementselector. And since the ID of form is invite form, let's use that one over here. Then create another variable for input box. I will call it input. Then let's use document.createElementselector. And for input box, I can simply write input over here. Then we have to create this ally and other elements using JavaScript. So let's use create element and store them in variables. So first let's create ally. So I will use document.createElement ally. Then we have to create this span, so use document.createElement and span. Now the text of this span should be value of this input box, so it will be span.textContent equals input.value. Then let's create this label document.createElement label, and then it has got the value confirmed, so let's write label.textContent equals confirmed. Then let's create this input type checkbox, so it will be document.createElement input, and then checkbox.type equals checkbox. Then let's create this edit button. I will call it edit btn equals document.createElement button. Then edit button dot text content equals edit. Finally, let's create the remove button. So I will call it const remove btn equals document.createElement button. Then remove btn.textContent equals remove. Now we have to wrap all these elements inside this ally. So let's use ally.appInside. The first thing we want to wrap is span. So we can add span over here. Then again, let's use ally.appInside. Then we have to wrap label. So it will be label over here. Then we have to wrap this checkbox inside this label. So now instead of ally, it should be label.appInside, and it will be checkbox. Now let's wrap these two buttons inside ally. So it will be ally.appInside edit btn and then li.appInside, remove btn. To make things easy, we can create a function called createAli and add all our code inside that function. We can then use the return statement. Now, since all our elements are ready, let's add event listener in form. So let's do form.addEventListener. And since it is a form, we have to add submit over here because form is being submitted. Then the first thing I want to do is to add the prevent default method because it will help to prevent it from submitting a form. So to add it, you have to add event over here and it will be event.preventDefault. Now, when we click on the submit button, all we have to do is we have to append this li inside this ul. So it will be ul.appInside and then li. So li is being created using this function, so we can't add a function name over here. So what we can do is we can create the li variable and then we can call the function over here. Now the only thing we are missing is this ul variable. So at the top we can write const ul equals document.querySelector. And the ID of ul is invited list, so I can use that ID. Now let's refresh the site and then let's add any name over here and click on submit button, and that is being listed below. Great. But let's see what happens if I try to submit it without any name, and it is being submitted too, which is wrong. So what we have to do is, whenever we submit without any name, we have to show this error message saying enter the name please. So open your app.js and here we can add the if else condition. So if the value of input is empty, then let's alert the error message saying enter the name please, otherwise you can append the li. Refresh the site again and this time you can hit the submit button and you get the error message. You write some name over here and submit, and it is being listed below. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll add a responded class so that it will be highlighted whenever we click on this confirmed checkbox. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.